Well, the Australian survivor castaways have been roughing it on the island for 34 days now. With the strategy to eliminate the strongest contestants, plans went haywire when Matt Rogers won immunity. Unfortunately for Samuel, Matt got wind of the plan to get rid of him and ultimately lost his trust. Take a look.
If we take control as the majority, Matt and his alliance are going to start to crumble and this game can be flipped on its head. So in case you've heard from people that your name's come out of my mouth, it's totally true. Yeah. Right? I don't intend on voting on it. You know, actions speak louder than words. I've heard it with you every single time.
Is that the only conversation just with those two girls you've had about me? You haven't gone to anyone else and said that someone's formulating a plan against you?
I mean, I love Sam. He's such a good guy. It's so emotional for him to do that.
I don't know who I can trust now.
You know what, Sam? As much as it hurts me, like, you've done it. You got to go.
Wow. Well, Samuel joins us now live from Brisbane. Good morning, Samuel.
Good morning, Danny.
Do you regret going against your original alliance with the Champions Tribe?
Not too much, no. I found out on the day that I was going home that when I gave Lydia the heads up, Matt knew on that day, and that's when I was cut out of that alliance. I had known that I was on the bottom, but I didn't figure it out until the night I went home, and by then, it's too late.
It's all so dramatic, isn't it? Last night, you were plotting to get rid of Matt, and then he went on and won immunity. So how disappointed were you when that happened?
That was not a good time. When Matt won that and he has the necklace around him, he's not going home. And the impetus, like, people wanted to flip on Matt. He had all this power. People didn't want to flip on Steve. They didn't see him as a threat. So all this momentum for Matt, it just meant nothing. Matt got wind of it. You know, Benji ratted me out. I ratted Benji out. It became between him and myself. And ultimately, he outwitted me. He had better talks, better conversations, and I'm the one that left.
All right, but every cloud has a silver lining. Last night, you became the second member of the jury. What sort of perks has that got for you?
It has the best perk of all, food. I remember when I went there my first night with Robbie and we feasted, I literally lay on the ground and I couldn't get up for multiple hours because I had eaten so much. Best night of my life, I guarantee it. And that's gonna keep happening every night now. Bountiful food, showers, a bed to sleep in. Who's the real winner here?
And look, fans of the show will know you're an intelligent guy, you're an astrophysicist, you have a PhD. Do you think that helped or hurt your game on Australian Survivor, and how?
I don't think it helped at all. It turns out that even if you know a lot about space, technology, computers, engineering, none of that's really relevant when you're on a Fijian beach with no technology. So I just, you know, I used it to bond a few times. I took the tribe down to the beach some nights and pointed out various things in the sky, the large Magellanic clouds, all the planets, etc. That was nice, but ultimately, it wasn't too much of a help.
So do you think if you had your time over, you'd play the game any differently?
Of course. I mean, I didn't win, so I obviously made some mistakes. And, you know, it's good to learn from those mistakes. So going back, I might tell myself, don't give Lydia a heads up. Matt will find out about it. Just coast along a bit further, wait until Matt doesn't have the necklace around him, and then go for him. But, you know, hindsight's 20/20, and I did what I thought was right at that point in time. So I try not to fault myself too much.
And given then that you can't win, who would you like to see to be crowned the sole survivor?
Well, obviously, I get along great with Matt. I've caught up with him multiple times since the show has ended. I'm rooting for Matt. But on the other hand, I love Benji's gameplay. It's so strategic, he's so manipulative, and that's what I think makes Survivor great. Benji's ultimately, I think, the one responsible for me going home. He managed to flip the votes from him onto me. I respect that. That's why I didn't try and rat him out or throw his name out at Tribal. So I'm curious to see, now that Benji's still in the game, what will he do next?
Well, don't forget to tune in to the next episode of Australian Survivor Champions versus Contenders, Monday at 7:30 p.m. on both the 10 and Win networks. Samuel, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, guys.